almost feel something coming on here.
Never do.
When Independence Day was offered to me, I was thrilled to do it just because it was reminiscent of all the big sci-fi films that I loved as a kid. We decided to use Alias Wavefront as a primary software package for the computer graphics unit. The F-18s were initially planned to be motion control model miniatures in the foreground and CG in the background. We did some tests. They turned out wonderfully. Our guys did a great job of making them photorealistic. So there are a lot of shots where people think that the foreground elements are model miniatures, but they're not. They're CG.
The movie itself involved a broad spectrum of effects. And in the case of particles, we did everything from this destruction beam, which is very whimsical and magical and yet powerful. And then on the other spectrum, we had particles doing smoke trails from missiles being fired by F-18s.
One of the things that we were really able to do was give them the ability to change things after they were shot. Suppose they shot something, it was planned a particular way in motion control, and they decided after cutting it together with other things that, you know, boy, it would be nice if the planes moved in a different direction.
Mark!
When we went from about 77 CG shots to over 200, 250 CG shots, that was when we really needed that flexibility.
I went through that experience of the hurricane in Niki and Kauai, actually, during the filming of Jurassic Park, and I thought it was very fascinating. As much as it's scary, it's also very fascinating to experience that brute force of nature.
Come on, come on!
The challenge of Twister was certainly creating the tornadoes. It was clear to us from the beginning that we would have to use technology, especially software technology, that we did not have available at that point in time when we started to look at the project, and that we would have to figure out how to really manipulate basically large number of particles.
Alias Wavefront fit in the program because we were looking for a software where we could simulate millions of particles to get the dynamics we needed in what happens in a tornado. And we had used the software before on the mask.
Smoking!
The particle system allowed us to easily go in and kind of tailor it to our needs, and that was very important for us to know. We didn't want to have to write some complete system from scratch, and that's why we're looking at Alias Wavefront and using its inherent ability to design your own clip effect.
We use the software not just for the particle animation, but we use it for taking apart structures and buildings. There's a shot in the movie where you see a barn being stricken by a tornado in the beginning of the film. The pieces were accomplished using particle type of animation so that we could control how the pieces come apart and react to the tornado itself, so both simulations happen in the same space.
Until digital applications, up to the moment, literally, that digital applications for filmmaking became a reality, I was thinking about getting out of the business. Railgun, it's a high powered essentially a rifle with a sight which allows you to see through buildings. What we were asked to create was an effect which allowed you to see the projectile. Alias Wavefront software, particularly particle systems, allowed us to manipulate the railgun effect to create this sense of ionization of the air, because it doesn't look like anything anybody's ever seen a gun do before. The X-ray effect had to be based on the reality of the scenes. And of course, during the live action pieces, you saw the actors moving through the sets. Then when you look through the viewfinder, the X-ray scope, you had to see that same set, and you had to see it essentially in infinity, because the X-ray scope could rack through this entire space. In this business, you need all the help you can get. People forget that digital image creation for motion pictures is just a few years old. Any help we get from anybody we deal with is valuable, and the help we've gotten from Alias Wavefront has been terrific.
Naughty Dog is a small development house that has a three-project deal with Universal Interactive Studios to create video game software. We started the development of Crash Bandicoot with the idea that we wanted to create a Warner Brothers cartoon character feel within a 3D game. So we brought in 2D classic cartoon animators to help us design the character. And then we animated him in Alias Wavefront to create what we hope was a squash and stretch classic Warner look. Naughty Dog decided that we wanted to push a couple of limits in Crash Bandicoot. One of them was in animation, and we felt the inverse kinematics and the clustering system that Power Animator uses was excellent, and we wanted to use Alias Wavefront to create the animation. We also wanted to create a really nice textured world. The world of Crash is very highly detailed, and Alias Wavefront allowed us to set enough textures and to manipulate a huge amount of textures within the world. We wanted to interface our proprietary tools with a software package that allowed us to do a lot of the things that we would have had to develop ourselves. And Alias Wavefront's open model allowed us to do just that. They've listened to our problems, they've solved our problems, and we're really excited to work with them in the future.
We have a philosophy on games, and that philosophy is, if it's no Scottish, it's crap. In the past, we've tried many, many graphics packages, and a couple of key things. One, we've got to recruit the best people, and the best people seem to want to work on the high-end machines, the best graphics packages. And when we say we use Alias Wavefront, that normally has a great effect on people. It offers us basically all the facilities that we need these days, and that's really important. We need great polygon animation tools, great texture mapping tools, motion capture. We have a motion capture studio. One of our games, Body Harvest, it's a game for the Nintendo 64 machine. It uses a lot of high-end 3D in that package. In that game, and we use Alias Wavefront for all the graphics in the game.
Alias Wavefront is my sketch pad. Anything that I do is done in real time. There's no slowdown in the process, and it's usable. Everything from the design stage to the finished game. And nothing comes close to Alias Wavefront.